Welcome to the Idyllic Scribblers Show, a community podcast that goes alongside the Idyllic Scribblers blog, which is a youth-oriented, objective-driven community platform where you can express your thoughts. So before we start today's podcast, I would like to thank all of you for the overwhelming response on the first two episodes. I've received lots of feedback and hopefully you'll be seeing improvements in the future. And coming to today's episode, as the title suggests, it is all about talent and hobbies. And we're going to talk about this a lot in detail, everything related to talent, hobbies and skill. And who would be better to talk about this than an actually talented person himself? And that's not me for sure, but that's today's guest. And he's magician Saransh Das. And it's pretty obvious from the name that he's a magician. He has performed numerous shows and won tons of contests. And trust me, I witnessed him personally and his sorcery is jaw-dropping. And it's too good to be actually true. So welcome to the show, Saransh.
Hi, Imran. Thanks for having me in the show.
Thank you so much for dropping by. And we're going to talk a lot about hobbies, talents and skill. So before we get into the important and much deeper topics, I would just like to ask you, can you please tell us your story and journey of becoming a magician?
Yeah, Imran, for sure. When it comes to my story, it starts 5 to 6 years down the line. When I was just 12, I saw a show that came on the History TV network. It was by Dynamo, Stephen Frame, a kid from Bradford. He used to perform magic. He used to perform magic for his livelihood, but in his school he was used to get bullied by the people, and somehow he learned magic from his grandpa, and that helped him to overcome and scare the guys who used to bully him. Soon he got into show business and he succeeded, and the world knows the name Dynamo. Yeah. This inspired me a lot. Like, he brought smiles to people, he went to different countries, he met people. So this fascinated me a lot. So magic is itself a mystery. And I love revealing mysteries, exploring new ideas, meeting new people. And this somehow means let me get into this stuff. And once I got into that, there was no looking back. I just loved the thing. I did it. I did it for 6 years. I learned it from various people, from magicians throughout the world. I read Indian books. At first, I started my journey by reading Indian books. Those Indian books are typical magic that is only limited to India. That was very predictable. But still, I used to manage to make videos that I posted on Instagram, YouTube. But those videos didn't make much views. And that somehow had pulled my motivation back, but still I continued, and I chose Facebook, Instagram at a time. I posted videos on them, I tagged people, and I got somehow some recognition which helped me grow.
Okay, so you,
so in this way,
so your inspiration was Dynamo. Okay, Dynamo is a pretty well-known magician. I've watched his shows a lot. And I'm probably sure like a lot of people know him, Dynamo, for sure. If they've heard about magic, they've probably heard about the name Dynamo. So you basically started by watching Dynamo, then you moved on to books, then you moved on to platforms. Okay, okay. And how many shows have you done?
It's around 80 shows till date. And I have managed to pull some more, but due to Corona and this outbreak, I couldn't get those shows. I had a show with Darshan Rawal that would have been great for my portfolio. But unfortunately, due to coronavirus outbreak, I couldn't.
That's great, actually, because I watched few of your shows and you also won a lot of contests, right? You won a lot of prizes as well. So you have pretty good credibility in the magic community, I guess. And you're making it big out there. And you're still in the learning progress, I guess. But still, you're making it big. You're learning.
Yeah.
You're growing. And you are also part of that community, right? That's a very close-knit group.
Yeah, actually, when it comes to magic, you cannot learn it on yourself. It's not that easy. Because it's an art. You have to explore it each time, and each phase is very difficult. It has when it comes to magic, I will define it in very simple words for you guys. Actually, magic is nothing but a simple combination of science and technology and a little bit of misdirection. It all depend on psychology, and somehow you can say it makes uses of sleight of hands and things like that.
Okay, that sounds tough actually, and I know it's tough because I watched you perform personally. So I know how difficult that is and how difficult it is to fool an audience of almost 1,000 people or so. So yeah, that must be difficult, but you easily defined it as you started by doing it from books. Let me tell you, it's not that easy. You can't just read books and do it right to the audience. So don't try reading books and start doing magic. It's not that easy. So that was your journey of becoming a magician.
Yeah, that was the first
Okay,
phase of
that's a
my
pretty
journey.
unusual talent
When I
actually, because I personally don't know anyone who's a magician. I've only watched shows, and I've always thought that this is not true. This can't be true. This is too good to be true. And there's no way an ordinary person can perform this out there. There must be skilled artists or so. So I had no idea that this could be a real thing. And when I met you, I came to know about this community. There's so many people out there performing magic, and it's a pretty great art actually. So that's about magicians. So that's one of the talents. There's many talents out there. So when you pick this talent, right?
Yeah, actually, I was very much fascinated by the kind of magic he did. It was something international, and I haven't witnessed that in India. So I thought of doing magic. I have tagged them, and they have somehow managed to take me into a community that is called Magicians on Break. We have a group in Instagram which contains magicians from 150 plus countries, and all have done shows on Greatest Got Talent shows, and they're amazing. They just teach magic to us. They also learn magic from us. The community keeps spreading. We pick magicians from different countries who are growing well, and we teach them to do
Okay, that's
better.
great. That's great actually. So there's a community out there. So and they pick you if you're really into this. So that's there.
Yeah,
And
exactly.
how many credit cards have you stolen since you perform magic?
Imran, you won't believe when I do shows after coming off the stage, I get people asking me, "What is magic? What is magic? Can you steal money?
Yeah.
Can you guess our ATM card numbers?" That's so funny. But I remember I have done a show with politicians, with a group of politicians, where I used two credit cards of the same person. I just asked him, "Can you allow me to guess your PIN?" He was like, "Seriously, it's impossible. No one can do that." I said, "Okay, if you are okay with it, I can do it." He said he's okay with it. So I did some magic. It was some kind of mentalism. It's called mentalism in magic. It's a genre of magic. So I guessed it in front of the crowd, and he was just stunned. He was literally
He
stunned.
got himself into trouble. So that was about
Yeah.
magic. That is your talent. That is your cup of tea. So since we were talking about talents and everything, so how would you suggest, or according to you, how should a person build his talent from scratch? If I were to start today, or if you were to start today, if you're doing magic, you discovered it right now, and if you were to start today, how would you build it from scratch? Because you have to start from somewhere to get on top, right? So, how did you start from scratch, or how would you suggest people to start from scratch?
For people who are getting into magic or any other hobbies they want, it's first of all depends on them how much they love it. If they love it, they can pull it to a long way. And it's not easy always from the beginning, because you have to just reach the milestone. After that only you can get the breakthrough into the path. But for that, one needs to just keep working constantly without thinking of the results. Once you get addicted to good results, you can never make it, because failures will come. For me, I have failed miserably on the stage in front of a crowd of 400, where I messed up on the stage itself. But the best thing of magic is that no one knows what happens next and what you're gonna do with them, so you can improvise it with your presence of mind. So somehow I pulled it, but it always happens. We're humans after all, right? So we make mistakes. So it's never easy for anyone to start from scratch and get to that level. But if you are determined enough, and if you like your hobby and you want to do it really, not for just showing off to the society, or just because your friend is doing that, or just because you saw something today and you are just attracted to that thing, you cannot make it like that. It's not that easy. If you want to really do something in your life, so you have to love it from the core of your heart. You have to follow that thing. You have to know what's best in that field. How can you be different in that field? How can you stand out from the crowd who is already doing the same? So this is the way I chosen for myself. And I used to do Indian magic a lot in the beginning, but that didn't pull much of the audience because Indian audience has already seen those
Yeah.
cutting people into half,
Okay, yeah. Indian
falling
magic,
and
right?
stuff
They
from
give
one.
you that ball thing and they get it out of your pant and all. They all do that weird. Okay.
Exactly. That is what I'm talking about. Actually, if I would have done that, the Indian audience has already seen that, so it was not that fascinating for them. And one thing you must think from the audience point of view also, what will the audience like? The audience always like trendy topics. And if you pick the trendy topics and make something out of it using your flavors, you can instantly reach to a good amount of
Yeah.
people. So that is what the formula one should use.
Yeah, correct. That's actually correct. You have to do something that's not out there that people want to see. You can't do something that people are already watching and expect them to like or expect them to give some attention. This is what happens in the movie industry, actually. I would like to add this here. So basically, I was just going through a few articles. So and there was an article about why Indian movies set in the village environment are not getting much attention. So basically, one guy replied to that because the vast majority of the Indian cinema industry is from the villages, maybe, or from the rural environment, or from suburban environment, and they've seen that environment their whole life. So they would never go to a cinema theater, pay for a movie, just to watch what they've been seeing their whole lives. They would prefer to watch some
Exactly.
big hero or actress or actor's film in the theater, which is set in a foreign environment, because they've never experienced that. That is something new for them. So that is why they pay, they go to the theater and they witness that. So because they've not seen it earlier. So they're looking for something new. That is the thing about capturing audience.
Yeah, exactly. I completely agree because now the Jio that has come to India has revolutionized the
Correct,
entire
yeah.
thing, and everyone had a good reach on the internet to search stuff and see diverse things. So then they are always hungry for new. So you have to completely push yourself each time to come up to their expectations and cater to their needs. So that is what I will suggest to the new upcoming buds who want to explore their hobbies and
That's correct,
talents.
that's correct. And also, there are many artists and talented people who back out. They basically back out. I often hear people say that they aren't doing something or performing or learning or participating only because someone else is already doing it. Just because, for example, you're a magician, doesn't mean that I don't learn magic, or if magic was my thing, I don't develop that just because you're doing it, right? I can't back out. I can't step out of the game. So there's also that.
Exactly. I have seen people, I have also many friends in my community, not from magic only. I have met many people from various spheres who are talented in different
Yeah.
fields. I have many friends who are singers, and I have seen few of them have backed out because they think that there are already too many singers who are already very
Yeah.
good. For them, my suggestion would be if you like singing, nobody can stop you from doing that. You can stand out someday because you are doing something different. If you are doing something different, the audience will get
Correct.
you and they will always promote you.
Exactly. And investment in knowledge always pays the best interest. That is what I would love to like to say.
Yeah, exactly. I agree,
Yeah,
sir.
so that was about building from scratch. Since you were talking about people wanting to see something new or capturing the audience, so I think we have to talk about platform here, because when it comes to talent, the most important factor is platform. So how would you describe the
Yeah,
importance
right,
of
sir.
platform, and how did you get one platform when you started performing?
It's the biggest thing one must think before getting into something. Without platform, we guys are nothing. The reach is everything. If you are doing something great and people cannot see it, it's of no use. So better one should think of few platforms. Like I would suggest people to go on YouTube or on Insta or on Facebook. But few things are there that they have to keep in mind. Like YouTube was very easy to do few years back, but after the scene of PewDiePie and Logan Paul, everything has changed. They have just done some stupidest things for which the YouTube policies have been stricter. So for me, I was earning nice money from my videos, but soon, since I was a new creator, I was put into restrictions. Like I have to cross 10,000 views and 4,000 hours of watch time, 1,000 subscribers. These all restrictions came with Logan Paul and PewDiePie's stupidity that they did with subfactual balls, and that made a huge loss for Google. And it's a private company; it can change its terms and conditions
Correct,
anytime
yeah.
it wants. So people have to keep in mind about these things, and they cannot get popularity or they cannot get the fame overnight. That is what they have to keep in their minds. And when it comes to me, I actually preferred YouTube. It was my first preference. I was earning good money. I was getting good views. But soon after this, my approach was quite flexible. I was on various platforms from day one. So when one door closed for me, YouTube turned their back to me. Like my income was completely stopped. So I turned my hands to Instagram, Facebook. These two platforms are trending nowadays. Now, Facebook is not trending that much because of its data breach and all. But I would suggest Instagram is one of the best platforms one can explore. So Instagram has a lot many user base, and people who are verified users, stars, singers, magicians, you can say anything. All are there on Instagram. And you can tag them, they also see, they held competitions, you can get into that, you can get recognition very easily from day one. Don't think about earning, you cannot earn from day one, you cannot get fame from day
Exactly, yeah.
one. It is a work, it is the work, constant work, you have to do it day by day so that you can get to that level.
Correct, correct. That's correct. That's exactly correct. And since so your initial platform is YouTube.
Yeah, my initial platform was YouTube, then I shifted to
Okay,
Instagram.
that's great. That's great. And what do you have to say about building your own platform? Because talking about
You mean
myself,
one?
I'm using two platforms right now because if I want to, I'm using three actually. I'm using Spotify, I'm using YouTube, and I also have my own blog. So basically, Spotify and YouTube are not my platforms. I'm using the public platform for that. And my blog is my own, right? That is my own website. So that's there. So what do you say? Like, should you focus on building your own platform or should you restrict yourself to the public domain?
According to me, it's my personal opinion. I don't know, people may vary with this, but according to me, people should keep it for the longer part of the journey because in your initial days, you cannot just focus on creating your own platform or building it
Yeah.
yourself because you have to take a shortcut to just gain the reach, and you have to just be flexible enough with your approach to different kind of social media platforms available today who are already getting a huge user base. So you must keep in mind that someday you have to build your own platform out of that when you have a good reach and you can direct people from that established platform to your platform. If you are getting it, I can just simplify it for you. Actually, when it comes to Instagram, I was there on the Instagram. I had just created one page. And I was just posting video like anything. People were just watching it going away, watching it going away, because I was not promoting it properly. I had no proper knowledge of doing the
Yeah.
same. I just consulted some of my friends who are already big stars. I was already in the community. So I asked people, I took suggestions, and they suggested me that you have to do promotions. You have to get established in an established platform first. Then you can think of your own platforms. Like when you're talking to blogs, I completely agree to that. Blogs are a good way to start with because they can gain popularity instantly because there are a lot of voracious readers who are on the internet. But when it comes to building your own platform like YouTube or something like that, you cannot pull it away in one
Correct,
day.
yeah.
You have to be with some labels or something like that to
That's
start.
difficult for an amateur artist actually to start his own thing. So even I would suggest basically to
Exactly.
have a web of platforms. Have your own thing, like your website. Start with a free website. At the same time, don't lose the opportunity of capturing audience in the other platforms, right? Go to YouTube, go to Spotify, go to any other platform out there. Just keep capturing the audience and keep redirecting them. Like get audience from YouTube and redirect them to your Instagram, or get them on your Instagram or redirect them to your YouTube. So just keep building a network, a web of platforms. So that would be perfect, I guess.
Exactly. I have few of my friends who have been to YouTube, and they were like, I have to get a good camera, I have to get a good mic, and they were like, they had a budget of 1 lakh to spend on a new channel. This is not the right thing to begin with. For me, people who are good at their art, who believe that they can explore their talents well, they are confident enough that people will like it. Because they're doing something different. They don't need much resources. They can just pull it up with few resources they have already. Like a phone
Yeah,
camera
that's
will do.
perfect actually.
A normal mic of 200 rupees will
Correct.
also do. And we are pretty much everywhere we can see that people who have grown from YouTube or something like that, they have all started with few and limited resources. Like you can talk about Kendrick
Yeah,
Mom. He's still recording on his phone.
correct. That's correct. He still records on his phone. So that just shows how important your talent and content is and not the equipment and hardware. People are going to
Exactly.
love it, even though it doesn't have good quality. But what's important is it should have good content. The quality should be top-notch. So that is the most important thing.
I believe that exactly. I believe the content should be best so that the people could relate and correlate and they can share. They will do the work. They will do the promotion. You don't have to do if your
Correct,
work is good. They will do the
yeah,
promotion.
exactly. And since we spoke about platforms, so which one do you prefer? An online platform or an offline platform, and why?
I believe both should go hand in hand because since I'm a magician, I can't be on online platforms only. People see me, I record videos and I post them on internet. They get amazed, they share, they enjoy. But few people have in their minds that hey, magic is not real. It's impossible. One cannot do this. So I always keep saying to my audience, seeing is believing. So you have to watch me live to believe, to just think what it's going on. You have to feel it. Magic is an art. You have to just appreciate it. You have to look into it. You have to feel it. You have to live it. So you need to come to my live shows. So that is what my approach is. I take both hand in hand.
Okay, so for the outreach part, you prefer online platform, and for the actual engagement, you prefer offline platform.
Yeah, exactly. I that's why I do shows. I have a complete schedule of my shows in a year. I have a few gigs that I perform in 1 year, then I change them in the next year because the audience get bored because I'm always posting stuff, the same stuff on the internet also. So people on online platform watch that, they get fascinated and they get redirected to my live shows. So
Exactly.
that
Yeah,
is
the
what I do.
online part acts like a trailer to your actual gig so that people look up to you offline. Yeah, that is what a lot of
Exactly.
artists are doing. But still, yeah, you need to start somewhere and you need to make a name for yourself. Only then you can translate this into an offline thing. So that's there. Okay, so
Exactly.
that was about platforms. Okay, so what would you say about the current state of hobbies and talents in India, especially if you were to make a career out of it?
When we look to the current scenario, it was not like that a few years back when I started. When I started, it was like people were, means I had to introduce magic. People were not that used to it. When I said I do magic, people thought I was doing some stuff that they used to see in the villages, like when people coming eating coins and taking out from
Yeah,
his pocket
correct.
and
There's a
something
lot
like
more to
that.
it, actually.
But exactly, there's a lot more to it. I wanted to show them the international picture of the same. I didn't want to show them the Indian magic only. I wanted to make magic a famous trending thing in India. So that is what I am working for. And when it comes to magic, it's not that simple. I cannot just say everyone that watch magic. They have to get attracted by something. I have to do something new each time to push myself to cater to their needs and expectations. So that is what I think one should do. And in India, the current scenario for a new thing has changed completely because people are like adopting many things. I've seen many people who are getting interested in rapping. This thing was very obsolete when we see a few
Exactly, it was
few
an
years
unknown
back,
thing,
because
actually.
people, yeah, exactly, people didn't accept rapping as a hobby or taking it as a career. It was like impossible for people to believe that someone in India is taking rapping into his profession and all. So when I see Gully Boy, films like Gully Boy, that's coming from underground rapping platforms and bringing it to
Correct,
mainstream
that's a huge
Bollywood,
leap.
people are changing. People are completely changing. The society is changing its mindset. Society is started accepting the new cultures that people are bringing from the Western countries, the talents that they are bringing, like hip hop, rapping, beatboxing, magic. You say anything, people are accepting it slowly. But still, India needs some more years to accept everything with pure heart, because all parts of India do not support
Correct, yeah,
all
exactly, that's
cultures.
true.
So somehow we need to be united. But I believe the internet has much power to spread one thing from one place to the entire country, and I guess it's doing well after the coming of
Correct, yeah,
Jio.
that's another huge
So
thing
let's see.
actually, because it has given access to internet to almost everyone. So, and because of internet, you
Yeah,
get
exactly.
to display your talent. At the same time, you can stay on the safer end. You don't have to sacrifice much.
Yeah,
Yeah, so
exactly.
that's there about the Indian society. But since we've spoken about the society, and the society, how it's accepting talents these days and how you can translate it into careers, in the end, again, it depends on the individual. So, and talent does not always translate to success. That's a fact, actually.
Yeah, that's the thing, you have to accept it, because it's not like that you will succeed each time. It's not possible. And for me, let's say I will take it as my career, but people in the society will still question me. Some people in the society will still question me, can you make money out of it? Can you earn your bread and butter with this? But if you believe in yourself, and if you believe that your talent is good, you are doing something different. There is always many obstacles that will come because you are doing something unconventional, and that is not what people will accept at once. You have to make them understand. That's your duty. You have to make them understand what you are doing, what you are doing for the society, what new things you are bringing to the society, what values you are spreading, what new cultures you are introducing to a new place. So you have to give something of their interest so that they get interested in your
Correct,
stuff.
that's correct. And people also need to come out with their talents. And we also hear about promising and people with potentials a lot, like a promising writer or a talented player or a potential player. But eventually they just fade away. They're just not there, right? So the people again need to hold on to their forte. People need to hold on to their talents. They just don't have to give up. And especially with this changing society, that gives more hope to people. So maybe more people will hold on to their talents. They will develop it, they will discover it, they will use them wisely. That is important. And actually displaying your talent is a personal contribution to yourself and the society, if you ask me. And another unknown fact, according to me, that a person's talents are not just for them, but they're for others. You have to serve them to others. Right, that is the thing, beauty of talent and other hidden skills that you have.
Exactly. When I go to a stage, I always think I am a chef. I am just
Yeah.
cooking food. And it's my way how I will garnish it and give it
Correct.
to my audience so that they will be attracted to the dishes. So that is what one has to think. And as you said, many are giving up on their talents because we have heard many have potential to be a good cricketer, be a good singer, but soon they fade away. This is because of the initial motivation that they're lacking and the what to say, the guidance
Yeah.
one should provide them. Because many of them are now picking up the unconventional things, hobbies and talents, which people from their place might not
Correct, correct,
resonate
yeah.
to. So one must get the initial motivation from somebody. And I think family is the biggest strength
Correct,
for
yeah.
anyone.
You have the support, you can do
So
anything.
families should get support. Yeah. With their support, you can do anything. So according to the family is the main building block for you
Correct,
to start
correct.
with. If you have their support, you can go
Exactly.
far.
So basically, people don't let the potential go waste. Work on yourself. That's there. So,
Yeah,
and okay,
exactly.
so that was about current state of hobbies and talents in India. And since we're talking about India and how the society is changing, if you ask me, the society has changed rapidly. As you said, because of Jio and other emerging internet services, the society has made a drastic leap, if you ask me. And there is more content on the internet
Yeah.
than ever. Indian channels are
Yeah, I
rising.
agree with that.
There's more music being made. There's so many indie artists coming out, and there are more platforms. If you ask me, there's TikTok. It's getting millions of views, but people are saying the state
Yeah.
of quality of content has gone down right now because, especially with the emergence of apps like TikTok, the quality is not up to the mark. Even on YouTube, it has become more cringy, if you ask me, and it's just not a great front for the Indian talent scene. So, what do you have to say about that, in short?
Yeah, I completely agree to you, Imran. Actually, when it comes to TikTok, I won't talk much about YouTube because I've already spoken a lot. But when it comes to TikTok, I have mixed opinions. For me, like TikTok can be a good platform, but it is so accessible to people that people are
Correct, correct,
misutilizing
yeah.
the same. They're making anything out of
Exactly.
it. Like you can't believe I have seen videos which are crap. Cannot watch them for a
Yeah.
minute. It's that crap, but still they're getting views
Exactly,
in millions.
yeah. That is the issue.
So that is what the other side of the coin that we must look. According to me, TikTok is a good platform. It can be if good creators come to it. But due to the hatred that has been spreaded due to the videos, that is, you
Yeah.
know what I'm talking about. The videos that are coming out, which are so cringy and
Yeah.
crap-like, when creators like those will be banned or stopped from making those videos, I guess TikTok can be a good platform because it has a very huge
Exactly, yeah.
user
There's so
base.
many people using it. And it is a good platform if you ask me. As a platform, it is good. Like, it suits the creator's needs. It's perfect. It's versatile. But the thing is, it is being misused by the audience, by the creators themselves. So, if you ask me, we need to change the creator landscape a little bit. So,
I guess the people who are working in TikTok, who are just managing the servers or checking on who the users, they must give some filters. Like YouTube put some
yeah, correct.
restrictions. It was somehow a good thing that TikTok can do so that it can be a cleaner and better platform
Yeah,
for
but we
newcoming
can't blame them
talents.
either because people are watching it. So,
Actually, TikTok is an infinitely scrolling down page which
endlessly
you
just
cannot stop
watch
or predict
content.
which video is coming. Yeah, exactly. That is what giving much views to the creators who are making
Yeah,
crap.
precisely. Yeah, correct. So that was about state of quality of content. And since the quarantine is going on right now, everything's under lockdown. So I would like to ask you, how are you promoting your talent, or how are you enhancing your talent during lockdown at home?
See, if you are basic, see, I don't have my team right now. I will completely agree to that. I don't have my cameras and I don't have my people who help me in the production business or the shooting business or something like that. But I have my basic equipments with which I had started. Like I have a simple gimbal, I have a simple selfie stick, I have a simple tripod, I have a simple phone which has a camera. That's enough for me. I have my skills. There, no one can
You have enough
take that from
to
me, right?
entertain people.
So I can. Yeah, I have enough to entertain people, and this is the best time that I have utilized to polish my skills, and I am learning new magic, and I'm bringing it to you guys soon. And every Sunday I'm posting videos on Instagram and getting huge responses because people are sitting idle in their homes watching Instagram. So for new creators, this is the best time they can utilize to make videos and promote
Exactly, exactly.
themselves.
Now is the
This is the
best
best time.
time because everyone is on social media right now. Everyone. Everyone. So it is very easy for you to get that potential audience. All you need to do is you need to be smart. You need to have a strategy in place. You need to capture those audience. You need to retain them. At the same time, you need to put out your content. So I think this is enough to make the best out of this situation, this current quarantine situation.
Yeah, exactly. And I am seeing upcoming new stars who have just become stars in this quarantine
Exactly,
period
yeah,
itself.
exactly, yeah. Quarantine has helped artists a lot.
They're getting,
Sitting at home, they're doing a lot.
I have seen many people who are getting views in
Exactly, yeah.
millions.
Which is also a wake-up call, if you ask me. Now people know what they can do just by sitting at home. They don't have to go outside. They don't need to have outlandish equipment. All they need to have is the will to put their content out there. So I think people are doing that very well. I've been watching a lot of content online. All of us have been watching content online. So
Yeah, that is the only thing you
correct,
can do
yeah,
in this
correct,
quarantine itself.
exactly. And people are coming with innovative ideas to spread awareness as well. They're combining their talent with awareness. So that's really impressive to see people do great things with their talents. Let it be singing, and also you have done a great video. I'll share that actually. You've done a great awareness video. And it has a magic incorporated into it, which I never imagined could be possible. So that's there. So people are using their
Yeah.
talents really well.
And when it comes to platform, YouTube and Instagram have really supported me a
Yeah.
lot also. Like I'm reading an LPU, as you know, Learning
Yeah.
Professional University. And there are just having competitions of things that are related to awareness in
Yeah,
coronavirus in
exactly.
India. And there And I had taken part in, and you are talking about that video, right? That is
Yeah,
one of the
correct. Yeah, it
awards.
won a
So
prize
for
actually,
that,
yeah.
yeah, exactly. So that is what I'm talking about. This is a wake-up call that
Exactly,
you're
yeah.
right.
People
This
have
is
been
the biggest
participating. They've
wake-up
been just
call for me.
participating. As you said, you won a prize. Even I won a prize 2 days ago. I won a writing competition. So, if you ask me, in normal days, I wouldn't have participated in the writing competition, maybe. So it is
I
bringing out the
completely
best out
agree.
of people. So that's a great thing to hear. So before we end it, I would like to go through the last segment. So what tips would you give to build and develop talents and skills in people if you had to give a few tips?
For the people who want to come into the mainstream in magic or any other field they want, like in music, in dance, in anything they want, if they're doing something different, if they think they have the potential, they can do it, they can carry it for a longer period of time, they can go on the long way without getting depressed by the failures, by the questions that the society will ask them
Yeah.
in their paths. If they're okay with it, if they can tackle it, if they think they can do it, they will do it. No one has to give them any tips. They can do it. They will do it. Definitely, they will do it. We have seen many people who actually have the zeal to perform, who actually have the dream to be there on a stage in front of a crowd of thousands. They will go. Definitely, they will find a way to go. We haven't have to say them a word. They know what to do. They only need the basic motivation and the guidance. That is, they should not be depressed by the failures they're
Yeah.
going to face. Because it's never too easy to get to that position without
Yeah.
a
Failure is
single failure.
important, very
If you're not
important
failing,
aspect.
yeah. If you're not failing, you're
Exactly,
not
yeah,
trying hard.
exactly, yeah.
Simple.
That's correct. You're not failing, you're not
So that
trying
is what
hard.
I would
That's
like
exactly
to
the same.
Yeah. That is what I want to tell to all the audience listening to us today, that if you are thinking that you are capable of doing something, go for it. Don't give it a second thought. Just go for it. Just do it. Give it a shot. Let's see if you fail. It's okay. Life is all about failures. The person who has succeeded is the one who tried once more, right? So let them go. Let them try it out. And this is the best time to give it a shot. And I think many of them will understand if they
Exactly,
give
yeah.
it a
You just
shot.
need to give it a shot first. You need to try it out. Only then you will know what to do, what not to do, how the response is. That's a whole different story. But you need to
Exactly.
take the initiative first.
Yeah. If you don't take the first step,
Exactly,
you will
yeah.
never reach there.
People need to explore and they need to observe as well. So keep watching out, keep observing, keep learning. That is the most important part. Keep learning. And at the same time, if it is possible, have mentors or have a model, so that you can learn from people, because you might have learned from a mentor, right? Magic is not something that you can learn on your own. You might have someone.
Exactly,
So have a mentor. At
I
the same
completely
time, you
agree.
need to commit to your talent. You need to develop your talent.
Yeah,
You need to
exactly.
commit to it. You need to develop your idealism. You need to blend yourself with the talent. So that is very important. And if you're going to make it a career choice, crystallization of talent with a career choice is important. So people should work on
Exactly.
that. And at the same time, have a unique point, create your own formula. There's always that question, why would someone watch me or why should someone watch him or her? So create that
Yeah,
formula of your
exactly.
own that makes you unique, at the same time attractive, and always have that why factor. Ask yourself why you're doing this or why you should do this certain thing or that. So always have that, and always find out the required skills and techniques. You need to learn the necessary skills to take yourself to the next level. That is what this is about. So, and knowing your strengths and weaknesses is also very important, so that you can focus on your strengths. And since we were talking about failure, it is very important, according to me, and it's the most crucial factor. You have to take constructive criticism. That
Yeah,
will take you
exactly.
to the
That is the
top.
most important. And I also believe, I also say to my audience that don't post videos for the sake
Exactly,
of
yeah.
posting only. Just take it seriously, make the content good so that it will be attractive enough for
Yes,
you to proceed.
that's correct. And at the same time, do the work. Work hard. This is not something that happens overnight. You can't become famous overnight, or you can't take your talent to the next level overnight. So do the work. Do keep working on yourself, on your skills, on your talents. Eventually, one day you will reach the point. That's what all of
Yeah,
this is
exactly.
about, reaching the top level, top tier. So that will only happen if you work hard, and failing as well. So you have to take the constructive criticism. So that's there. And another important thing, according to me personally, I feel, is you have to celebrate your progress.
Yeah, that's
Yeah,
a
because
very important thing. You have to have people around you who appreciate you from the core of their heart. They're honest to you. They will be happy with your success. You can't celebrate
yeah.
it alone. You just have to be happy with
Correct.
small things, and you have to
Exactly,
celebrate those
exactly.
things.
Because only when you celebrate success, whether it is big or small, you encourage yourself to do it again. So that is very important. Celebrate
Exactly.
your progress, celebrate your success, celebrate yourself, celebrate your talent. So to summarize it, just prepare yourself, improve yourself, and showcase. These three things are important.
I completely
Yeah,
agree.
so that was our talk on talent and everything related to talents and skills. Thank you so much, Saransh, for coming to the show.
Thanks a
People
lot
will
for
get a
having
great
me here.
insight. Even I got a great insight into the journey and all it takes to build your talent or everything related to platform. So it was really informative, really fun talk. And thank you so
Thanks.
much,
And I
everyone, for
really
tuning
appreciate the
in.
audience.
We will be back with more podcasts. The blog is also launching soon. Next week it will be out for sure. There's few things I've planned, and there are a lot of changes that I'm making. I'm listening to all your feedback and criticism. There's changes that you'll be noticing soon. Even with the blog, I'm trying to improve the writing quality. It is not launched yet, but when it launches, I'm planning to bring out a mini series as well. So if any of you is interested, you can always send your content. If it's not big enough to be a blog, it can be in the mini series. And there's also full-size blogs coming out. So stay tuned for that. And the podcast will go on every week. So thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in. It was a great experience talking to you, Saranj.
Yes, thanks, Imran. You are also
thank you
doing
so
a
much.
Great job to encourage people to come and join a podcast and share their experiences. Thanks for having me.
Yeah,
here.
So thank you. And I request all of you to stay safe, maintain social distancing, which is the need of the hour right now. And all of you know what to do. So I don't have to tell that. So thank you so much, everyone. Have a great day. Thank you, Saranj.